Now, as I mentioned, a film shot at the First World War replica trenches in Suffolk is on release to local cinemas. Tim Curtis, who made the very popular Life of the Deben documentary, is behind this film. It's called The War Just Outside Ipswich. It's going to be shown at the Riverside in Woodbridge on Wednesday. There'll be a Q&A afterwards as well with the team, including Taff Gillingham, who is one of the owners of the trench. And Tim and Taff both join us now. Afternoon, Tim.
Good afternoon, Lesley.
Hello, Taff.
Hi, Lizzie.
So, starting with you, Tim, I know this was done to try and support cinemas, try and support people through the lockdown. How did you get the idea?
Well, the idea came up when we filmed Stanley's War there in 2018 at the trenches, and it was the first time I'd ever been there. And I thought, wow, this is amazing. And the more time I spent there and got to know Taff and heard about all the productions that were filmed there over about 20 years period, it just seemed an obvious story that didn't seem to have been told.
Was it easy to do? I'm assuming you did this through lockdown, did you?
Yeah, well, when we filmed Stanley's, we filmed a lot of behind-the-scenes footage, you know, the camera crew and stuff like that. And we filmed a nice lengthy interview with Taff about all the productions that have been there and all the stories. And during lockdown V1, we thought, you know, this is very interesting. And we started putting it together then.
Yeah, so that's right. So the time, you were able to do things in the time with material you'd already got.
Yeah, as you know, lockdown one, it was beautiful weather. And after about a couple of weeks, I better do something.
Stir crazy.
Yeah, it started coming together.
Just take me through what's in the film, just whet our appetites.
So it's basically a behind-the-scenes look at this incredible film facility in a field in Suffolk. Well, it's a big field, and there's lots of extra bits. Taff talks us through a lot of the old stories, when Downton Abbey was filmed there, Journey's End, Private Peaceful, Stanley's War, and we get a real sense of what it is to make films in this facility, and also maybe what a soldier's life would be like in during the war.
Did you use any of the cuts from the film as well? So do you get people to see sort of like some of the reenactment side?
Yeah, that's what we try to do. Is we've shown a scene or two, and then we've kind of either before or after show how we made it.
Taff, obviously we can hear the full interview, and there's a Q&A on Wednesday as well, so people can ask you questions. But how did the trenches, just briefly, how did they all happen in the first place?
Oh, well, I suppose really Khaki Devil came about because I'd been doing historical advice for several years. And then when the BBC did a series called The Trench back in 2001, at the end of the interview, when they'd taken me on as the advisor, I just said, where are you going to get all the gear? And the upshot was that Kev Smith and I set up a company called Khaki Devil to provide all the uniforms, the equipment, the weapons. And it went on to provide specialist extras and vehicles and goodness knows what else. And then having literally got everything for production, so the production company could come to us and we were just at a lot, they'd then say, well, I don't suppose there's any chance you could build us trenches. So to begin with, we were building them all over the country for different film and TV jobs and just thought this is a bit mad. You know, we'd drive up to North Yorkshire, build a trench for Blue Peter for a week, 2 or 3 days filming it, and then come back home with all the bits. I thought, why don't we just find somewhere near us? And we were just lucky enough. We found a fellow called Jerry Hall, who lived on the outskirts of Ipswich, who had some farmland. The upshot was that he agreed to let us build trenches there, and we just split the location fee. And, 20 years later, we're still there. Sadly, Jerry now isn't. He passed away last year, sadly, but the site still is, and we're still making film and television.
And because you will never do anything by halves, and I did question whether I dared to use the word replica when I actually did it, but they can't be real trenches, whatever. But they are, I mean, because you've done them from the German perspective and the English perspective, haven't you? So that when people film, they are getting as good a feel about it as possible.
Well, I mean, that's the idea. I mean, at the end of the day, it is a film set, and it's very important to say that. One of the reasons that we're building the separate site at Great War Huts at Horsted is so that we can build proper trenches exactly as they would be. But the film trench ones are built. We've opened up the angles. We've improved the sight lines. We've made them wide enough to get camera crews down. We've made sort of islands where you can go all the way around, because I've never met a cameraman and a director yet that didn't want endless marching 3 feet through the mud. So it's got all those sort of little cheats in. But yes, we've got a very different, very distinctive look up on the German trenches, so that, you know, in the same documentary, you would know that you're now back in the German trenches, not in the British ones.
Come on then, Tim. Did you want endless marching through mud in Stanley's War?
Definitely.
They all want endless marching.
First thing I asked for. Mud. And
glorious mud.
Misery. Actually, would you mind if I just made one correction? The film is actually on Friday.
Oh, is it? Oh, I beg your pardon. I'm sure I found it on their website on Wednesday. But anyway, carry on.
Well, I'm going to go.
It's on Friday.
Okay,
hopefully it's on Friday.
Friday at the Riverside. Okay, and Johnny is nagging. I'm going to get him to check that out for us as well at the moment. So sorry about that. Okay, cool. So I'll make sure. Yes, I don't want everyone turning up on the wrong day. So the Riverside on Friday. Chance.
Yeah, and it's actually sold out.
Has it? But you're hoping lots of people will show, aren't you?
Yeah, we are. We hope. It's basically, we've got a license to show it at Suffolk Independent Cinemas. And that was the deal. Originally, we wanted to show it on Armistice. Obviously, that didn't happen. But we hope local Suffolk cinemas will take advantage of it.
And it's been really tough for them, hasn't it?
It has. And some may not come back. Some are in trouble. And, you know, all the production companies that gave us the clips, I think, realised that if there's no cinemas to show films in, you know, they've got the big cine worlds and all that stuff. But these little independents, we need them to stay around.
Yeah, and for you as well, it must have been tough. And you've got work that you've had to cancel?
Yes, we had to put whole production on hold. But I've come through okay. I've been quite lucky, actually.
And Taff, I know that you've had support, haven't you? Government support?
Yes, I mean, it's been a very tough time for us because, if no one's making films to show in cinemas, then they're not asking us for the uniforms and equipment, so this is great. I mean, this is a brilliant opportunity to sort of showcase what goes on in Suffolk, and hopefully there'll be, you know, there are plenty of people who work in the film industry who live around Suffolk, and hopefully those of them that don't know anything about what we do, you know, will see this and sort of bear it in mind for the future.
I think it sounds really interesting, and I guess once all this is over, it could probably go online or get to be a DVD so we can all get to see it as well. Tim, just so on Friday at the Riverside Theatre, and there's a Q&A and Stanley's War as well?
Yes, so we'll start with Stanley's War, a film that was made at the trenches, and then we'll have a film about the trenches.
Brilliant. And then you can ask who's going to be at the Q&A. So you'll be there, Tim, and I know you'll be there, Taff, won't
you? Taff, Kev Smith, who part of the setup with Khaki Devil. And we will be getting people to write questions down rather than speaking out in a COVID distance cinema.
So it's also tricky, isn't it, as well? It's very difficult.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sorry I got the day wrong, but I'll make sure I mention it several times between now and then to make up. And it's sold out anyway,
There's another showing in January at Woodbridge, and there's one confirmed at Ipswich Film Theatre in January.
Brilliant. Keep letting me know when they're booked in. I'll give them mentions. Thanks for joining us.
We'll do.
Can I just make the point that the trenches aren't open to the public?
Yeah, okay.
On a piece of private farmland, there are no public rights of way across it. We've had a few people wandering around and having a look through lockdown period, it is all private property, and it's not a playground. It's really the best place to be avoided unless you're a film crew, with all the safety stuff that comes with it.
And which is why, as you say, you're going to be doing some that people can actually come and look at the visitor centre as well. Taff Gillingham, Tim Curtis with us. So Friday, the Riverside Theatre in Woodbridge, but they're sold out already. But keep your eyes open for that film then, and Stanley's War, a chance to go along and find out more. And as he says, so in January, another showing at the Riverside, also which film theatre. And if you are a local cinema and you would like to have a look at it, I think if you go to Life on the Deben, you'll get all of Tim's details there. If not, come to me and I can pass them on.